Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in to today's second video. Doing JMA Friday for today's second video. So as always on a Friday, we're having a look at the weather for the month here with Japanese on the CFS Meteor Models, and this will just about go to the very opening day of September. So I shall get on with that for you in a moment. Just to say that the first video release today was our 6 a.m. UK weather forecast revamped and upgraded. I've got 10 to 14 day coming up for you later on today as well. Please like, share, subscribe on all today's videos and content. Thank you so much everybody for doing that. Right, we're going to start off with the week one 500 millibar height anomaly from the JMA from the Arctic and the North Pole view down. So this of course is the North Pole just here. This is the wider Arctic circle around there, and they've got big patches through here. Blue is extrapolating to below average heights, which is low pressure. Yellow, orange and red to above average heights, which is high pressure. These are broken down into week periods. The first week period will take us from today, the 4th, through to the 11th of August. So this next week we'll have a trough of below average heights to the north and east of the UK and Ireland, and a ridge of above average heights of high pressure to our west and southwest. So low pressure to the north and the east, high pressure to the west and south, and that will leave wind on a northwesterly direction. So it looks rather cool and showery for week one. Quite a significant change for week two, as a big area of high pressure takes over to the north, a large blocking feature, which would normally be bad news for our summer prospects, but it's sending a ridge down the western side of Europe as well, with a trough of low in the middle of the Atlantic that should combine to pull up much warmer southerly winds. This, of course, is going to be the 11th to the 18th of August, so the middle part of the month looking significantly warmer there. And a little bit more settled, but this trough of low pressure will be threatening rain and thunder from the Atlantic. And then week three and four will take us from the 18th of August to the 1st of September, with some above average heights just to our south. And by blocking area of high pressure, looks like going more toward the Canadian side of Greenland. So this area of high pressure over France and Europe should start to send the jet stream north, especially if the areas of low pressure ease off a little bit. It might still be rather unsettled for the north and the west, but for the southeast, we probably turn drier and warmer there into the second half of August. So let's have a look at tropical and mid-latitude view to confirm all of that. So we can't see the Arctic, Greenland, North Pole, Scandinavia, all those areas off chart up here. UK and Ireland, top right-hand corner of the chart as we're looking at it. Reminder of that week one 500 millibar height anomaly from the 4th to the 11th of August, with the above average heights to our west and southwest, and the below average heights to our north and northeast up here. Should leave us with a northwesterly wind. So temperature anomalies for week one are coming out cooler than average. We're in the blues there, another below average week to come. And as far as precipitation anomaly is concerned, still a little bit above average as well. So a cool and unsettled week to start us off for week one. Week two sees that ridge building over the country, and it extends north as well, with low pressure out in the Atlantic. So it's warming up in this week. It's a little bit transitional. It still looks a little bit on the cool side just to our south, actually. But generally, we go back to the yellows, which is 1 to 2 degrees above average. So, yes, a warm-up taking place there. And as far as precipitation is concerned, it's also turning drier. So a little bit wetter than average Scotland and Ireland, but for England and Wales, drier and significantly warmer, I would have thought. And then weeks three and four will take us from the 18th of August, the 1st of September, with some higher pressure just to our south. Jet stream should be starting to shift northwards a little bit there. The temperature anomaly is still nothing to get that excited about. It's around to slightly above average, like half degrees, like that, up to 1 degree. And it's a little bit more unsettled again, actually. It's above average rainfall. A bit surprised about that. Oh dear. So still rather unsettled even into the second half of August there with the JMA. Now let's have a look at CFSB2 and see how that compares. So again, it's a 500 millibar height anomaly from the Arctic of North Pole view down. This is going to take us from the 4th to the 10th of August. Perfect agreement between the two models, actually. We've got a ridge through here, and it will extend to there as well, probably, with below average heights to the north and the east and into the country. Leaves us with a northwesterly flow and rather unsettled, courtesy of that trough of low. Week 2 is the 11th to 17th of August. Higher pressure building across much of the continent. What's going on through this white area? Is there still low pressure coming through in that white area in reality? And then week three, also looking very similar to the JMA. This is the 18th to 24th of August. High pressure there, much closer to us over Scandinavia. Low pressure is out here. And that should bring the wind up from a southerly or southeast direction. So it should be significantly warmer or hotter. And week four, also looking very similar to the JMA, the 25th of August of the last day of the month, 31st. Again, with the above average heights to our north and the east. Low pressure is in the Atlantic. And probably, again, bringing the wind from a southerly southeast direction. Should be a significantly warmer second half to August compared to the first half with that, if not overly settled. Temperature anomalies for week one from the 4th to the 10th of August. They're coming out below average. We're not alone. Most parts of Europe looking really cool as well. Week two is also a little bit on the cooler side, actually. It's the 11th, 17th of August. So it's not as cool, but generally it's still average to cooler than normal there. Taking a while to warm up, but we finally get there into week three. It's the 18th, 24th of August, where we go slightly above average. Most parts of Europe having a significant warm up as well. And then week four is the 25th to the 31st of August. And that one also coming out a little bit above average with the temperature and night. So I won't go overly excessive with hot weather, but certainly looks warmer in the second half of August to the first half. And then finally, precipitation. So week one, 4th to the 10th of August, still looking a little bit on the uncertain side, rather above average rainfall, if anything. Week two, also a bit above average for precipitation, you know, 17th of August. That one also coming out rather wetter than normal. And week three, look at this, 18th to 24th of August. So for England, Wales, anyway, it's just about a bit above average. I can only think that the model is picking up on thunderstorms and, you know, rain coming up from the south with that. And by the time we get through to week four, we've got no particular signal, but there's no real indication that it's turning all that dry, to be honest. So we've pretty much lost the signal by then. It is drier than average out towards Scandinavia, but it's wetter than average just to our west of the Atlantic. So, it's a mixed one, this. It looks like we're going to have a good go at setting things down, drying things out, warming things up. As we've been saying in the videos, and this is bearing out being Jeremy Friday as well, I think it's a question of how far we go with that. How successful is that drying and warming process? It looks a struggle, I have to say here, reading between the lines with the JMA. We will get a warm up. It is going to become warmer than it has been over the last two or three weeks, I think. But how far we get with that remains to be seen. The Atlantic is in quite a buoyant phase along with the jet stream. So it's going to be interesting to see, you know, how significant change is in the second half of August. Will we just shift from cold rain to warm, to cool rain, from cool rain to warm rain, or will we properly dry things out at least for a while? We'll keep you posted. That's how it's looking today. Anyway, remember, just a snapshot of what the two models are showing. They could look completely different when we look at them again next week. So any forecast beyond 5-7 days comes with big hail warnings and large pinches of salt attached. We're going to be back shortly with your 10 to 14 day. That's going to include all rubber regular features. Come back for that a little bit later on. For Jeremy Frey for this week, that's all now. And thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.